Hello students, how are you? Hope you are fine and staying home. This is gonna be another class on chapter 4. This is the most important class cause I am discussing some most important topics of this chapter. So please don't miss this class. And while you're sitting on in front of your laptop or your mobile phone to attend the class, please just sit with the book, textbook. This will help you to better understand. So now I'm gonna start the class. In previous class, I just finished the registration process of the partnership business. Registration of the partnership business, just finished it, and now this is the most important part, classification of partners. Several questions just came from this chapter in previous exam, so you have to remember it very clearly about this classification. So we know that in a sole proprietorship business, the owner is one person, a single person handle the business or control the business. But in partnership business, there are more than two person, and most of the people just they have a wish to do the business, it is very much easy to start the business. So if you think about starting the business, partnership business, there is no much legal complications, just your willingness, the partner's willingness will enough for the starting the business. And there are several type of partners, and first one is ordinary partner, second one is sleeping partner, third one nominal partner, and fourth one is quasi partner, fifth one is limited partner, and last of all, sixth one is partner by holding out. Now this is important, just pay attention on the class. Ordinary partner, in ordinary partner you will find out some characteristics. First one is partners invest capital in the business and actively participate in the operational activities of the business. That means the partners who are investing capital and also participating on the operational activities of the business, that means participating in the operation of the business, they are called ordinary partner. And they have unlimited liabilities, they equally share the profit and loss as per deed of agreement, and gets remuneration if mentioned in the agreement. If it is mentioned in the agreement that they will pay remuneration against their work or against their what kind of against their job, and if it is possible while it is mentioned in the agreement, now that means you have to put it down on the agreement first, then you will execute it. So ordinary partner, just remember that ordinary partners are those persons or those partners who are investing capital on the business and also participating on the operation of the business, and they have the unlimited liabilities. So this is ordinary partner. Sleeping partner, sleeping partner, that means you, I think you will understand easily that sleeping, that means who are not awake. Are in case of partnership business, that means who are not actually working, sleeping. While you are sleeping, that means you are just your working activities are just shut it down, your working activities. Sleeping partner, in case of sleeping partner, the partners are investing money or investing capital, but they don't work any type of work. They don't participate in the operational activities of the work or business. So because they don't work in the operational activities, so that's why they are called sleeping partners. But they invest money, they invest capital on the business, into the business, and also got the profit as per agreement, shared the profit as per agreement. A sleeping partner has the limited liabilities, their liabilities are limited, they share the profit. Then they main characteristics, you can say that they just invest the capital, but they don't work any type of work, operational work. So that's why they are called sleeping partner. थर्ड वन इज नॉमिनल पार्टनर. नॉमिनल पार्टनर मीन्स द पार्टनर्स हु आर नॉट इन्वेस्टिंग कैपिटल एंड ऑल्सो ऑल्सो डोंट पार्टिसिपेट इन द ऑपरेशन ऑफ द बिजनेस बट द बिजनेस यूजेज देयर नेम देयर गुडविल दे दिस टाइप ऑफ पार्टनर्स आर कॉल्ड नॉमिनल पार्टनर. दैट मीन्स the persons who are allowing the business to use his name, that is called nominal partner. The goodwill is the main capital of this type of partners. Their capital is their goodwill, their name. So this is called nominal partner. Who is allowing the business to use their name? This is called nominal partner, and they don't invest the capital and doesn't participate in the business operational activities. But they have no they do not have the unlimited liability. Their liabilities are limited, and if it is. If anybody lends money to the firm considering him as a partner and is able to prove it, then the partner shall be equally liable. Though they don't invest the capital, they don't participate in the operation of the business, but if anybody lend him some money and they can prove it, obviously this partner will be responsible to return back this money. So this is called nominal partner. He or she will be liable to return the money. Just try to remember the main characteristics. Ordinary partner who are investing capital, also participating in the operational activities. They have unlimited liabilities. Sleeping partner who are investing capital but doesn't work in the operational activities, and their liability is limited. And nominal partner, they don't invest the capital, but they are allowing the business to use his name, goodwill. So this is called nominal partner. Fourth one is quasi partner. This type of partner does not withdraw the money invested as capital and retains in the business as a loan. That means, and this type of partner does not withdraw the money. At the time of retirement, the quasi partner does not withdraw their investing money or investing capital, and he just lending this money to the business. So this is called quasi partner. তার মানে হচ্ছে যে এই অংশীদাররা যখন রিটায়ারমেন্টে যায় তখন কি করে, তখন তারা ব্যবসা থেকে টাকাটা রিটায়ারমেন্টে চলে যাওয়ার সময় তখন তারা ব্যবসা থেকে যে টাকাটা তারা ইনভেস্ট করেছিল সেই টাকাটা তো তাদের ফেরত নিয়ে যাওয়ার কথা ছিল, কিন্তু তারা ফেরত নিয়ে যায় না। তারা কি করে, তারা হচ্ছে এই টাকাটা ব্যবসায়ীকে ধার হিসেবে দেয় আবার বিনিয়োগের জন্য, ঠিক আছে, মানে আবার বিনিয়োগ করে। দিস টাইপ অফ পার্টনার্স ডোন্ট উইথড্র দ্য মানি অ্যান্ড ইনভেস্টেড ইট অ্যাজ এ ক্যাপিটাল অ্যান্ড রিটেন ইন দ্য বিজনেস অ্যাজ এ লোন। আচ্ছা, ইনফ্যাক্ট দিস সৌরভ পার্টনার্স আর দ্য ক্রেডিটার্স টু দ্য বিজনেস। দ্যাট মিন্স দে আর দ্য ক্রেডিটার্স টু দ্য বিজনেস, মানে পাওনাদার, ক্রেডিটার্স, দে আর দ্য ক্রেডিটার্স কলস দে আর লেন্ডিং মানি টু দ্য বিজনেস, সো দে আর দ্য ক্রেডিটার্স। এনি অর্ডিনারি পার্টনার রিমেন্স ইন দ্য বিজনেস ইন সাচ এ ওয়ে উইদাউট পাবলিশিং নোটিস, দেন হি অর শি উইল বি লায়াবল টু দ্য থার্ড পার্টি ফর দ্য অ্যাক্টিভিটিস অফ দ্য বিজনেস। কোনো পার্টনার যদি, কোয়াসি পার্টনার যদি কোনো নোটিস ছাড়াই ব্যবসায় এভাবে থেকে যায়, আর সে রিটায়ারমেন্টে চলে গেছে কিন্তু নোটিস দিয়ে কাউকে জানানো হয়নি, এটা কোনো বাইরের থার্ড পার্টিকে জানানো হয়নি, সেক্ষেত্রে ওই থার্ড পার্টি যদি কোনো কারণে ওই রিটায়ার্ড অফিসারকে কোনো কারণে, রিটায়ার্ড পার্টনারকে যদি কোনো কারণে ক্লেম করে, কোনো কিছু তার কাছে ক্লেম করে, তখন সে কিন্তু ওটা দিতে বাধ্য থাকবে। যদিও সে রিটায়ারমেন্টে চলে গেছে, তার কোনো ধরনের কোনো লেনা দেনা নেই, সে শুধু তার টাকাটা কী করছে, ইনভেস্ট রিইনভেস্ট করছে, সে উইথড্র করছে না, ক্যাপিটালটাকে উইথড্র না করে কী করছে, রিইনভেস্ট করছে। কিন্তু এটা যদি নোটিস দিয়ে কাউকে জানানো না হয়, কোনো থার্ড পার্টিকে যদি জানানো না হয়, সেক্ষেত্রে কিন্তু কোনো থার্ড পার্টি যদি ওই ব্যক্তিকে ব্যক্তির কাছে কোনো কিছু ক্লেম করে বা কোনো অ্যাক্টিভিটিসের জন্য দায়ী করে, তখন কিন্তু অবশ্যই সেই গোয়াসি পার্টনার দায়ী থাকবে। সো দিস লাইন জাস্ট মেনশনড ইট, ইফ এনি অর্ডিনারি পার্টনার রিমেন্স ইন দ্য বিজনেস ইন সাচ আ ওয়ে উইদাউট পাবলিশিং নোটিস, দেন হি অর শি উইল বি লায়াবল টু দ্য থার্ড পার্টি ফর দ্য অ্যাক্টিভিটিস অফ দ্য বিজনেস। দ্যাট মিন্স কোয়াসি পার্টনার ইজ দিস টাইপ অফ পার্টনার ডাজেন্ট উইথড্র দ্য মানি ফ্রম দ্য অ্যাজ ফ্রম দ্য বিজনেস which he invested as a capital, just he just lending the money to the business, and that's why they are called creditors to the business. Limited partner, if liability of a partner is limited as per deed of agreement, or if any minor is taken a partner legitimately to facilitate him with the consent of other partner, is called a limited partner. That means where the partner has the liability of the partner is limited, they are called limited partner. And also minor can be minor, that means below the 18, the age is below the 18, and they can be also a partner if other partners just give their consent, and that will be called limited partner. The liability of such partner is limited, does not take part in the business operation, and any minor person can also be such a partner on the basis of deed of agreement, but you should mention it on the agreement. And partner by holding out, when any person introduces himself as the partner of a business verbally, written, or any other manner, though he is not a partner, he is called partner by holding out. That means ami just tomaderke bujhanor jonno bolchi je je ongshidarra tar achorone তার কথাবার্তায় বা কোনোভাবে কোনো আচরণে বুঝায় যে সে আসলে ব্যবসায়ের অংশীদার বা ব্যবসায়ের পার্টনার, বিজনেসের পার্টনার, বাট আসলে অফিসিয়ালি কাগজে কলমে হি ইজ নট দ্য পার্টনার, হি ইজ নট আ পার্টনার, বাট হি জাস্ট ইন্ট্রোডিউস হিমসেলফ অ্যাজ এ পার্টনার, বাট হি ইজ নট অফিসিয়ালি আ পার্টনার ইন দ্য পেপার। সো this type of partner called a partner is partner by holding out. If anybody being influenced by his attitude lends money to the business, then such partner shall be liable. যদি এই ধরনের পার্টনারকে কেউ কোনো থার্ড পার্টি কোনো তৃতীয় পক্ষ টাকা ধার দেয়, তাহলে অবশ্যই এই ধরনের পার্টনার কী করবে, ওই টাকা পরিশোধ করতে বাধ্য থাকবে। সে কারণ হচ্ছে যে সে ভাবে আচরণে বোঝাবে সে পার্টনার, আসলে তো অফিসিয়ালি সে পার্টনার না, কিন্তু তার আচরণে সে যদি পার্টনার বোঝায়, অবভিয়াসলি তাকে টাকা কেউ ধার দিলে তাকে সেটা পরিশোধ করতেই হবে, হি অর শি উইল বি লায়াবল। সো দিস ইজ দ্য সিক্স টাইপস অফ পার্টনার। ফার্স্ট ওয়ান ইজ অর্ডিনারি পার্টনার, সেকেন্ড ওয়ান ইজ স্লিপিং পার্টনার, থার্ড ওয়ান ইজ নমিনাল পার্টনার, ফোর্থ ওয়ান ইজ কোয়াসি পার্টনার, ফিফথ ওয়ান ইজ লিমিটেড পার্টনার, অ্যান্ড পার্টনার বাই হোল্ডিং আউট। Okay, now another important topic is dissolution of partnership. Dissolution of partnership business. Dissolution of partnership business, what it is? Dissolution of partnership business, that means this is the end of the business. Okay, dissolution, and there are many ways to dissolute the business. First one is dissolution by mutual consent. That means if all the partners are agreeable to the dissolution process of the business, then it will be easy. According to Section 40 of Partnership Act, all the partners of the firm mutually dissolute the business. That means all the partners are just agreed to end up the business. Number two, forced dissolution. Forced. When it is forced, for two reasons it can be forced. First one is all but one or one of the partners became bankrupt. All but one or one of the partners became bankrupt. That means if one partner just became bankrupt, and the business is involved with the any illegal activities, then there will be forced dissolution. So for two reasons the business can be forced dissolution. First one is if any partner become bankrupt, or second one is if the business becomes illegal. So this is forced dissolution. Third one is eventual dissolution. That means so if any event happens, then a dissolution will also take place. What type of events can be responsible for the dissolution? First one is if specific time span of the business ends. That means for a specific time period, if the business is established for a specific time period and this time period just end, then you have to eventually dissolute the business. Second one is if the specific task for which the business started is finished. That means if you establish a business for any specific objective and the objective is just achieved, then you have to eventually dissolute the business. Third one is in case of death of any partner, if any partner just die, you have to dissolute it. Fourth one is if any partner is declared bankrupt by the court, if any partner just declared bankrupt by the court. Court, if court is declaring any partner as a bankrupt, that means you have to eventually dissolute the business. Number four, dissolution through notice. The partnership business, according to the Act, any partnership business, if one partner just through the notice just want to dissolute the business, then this type of dissolution will happen. Here you can see Section 43 of the Partnership Act states that partnership business can be dissolved through the notice by any partner of his desire to quit the business. That means if any partner just giving the notice of quitting the business, that will be enough for dissolution through notice, dissolution of that business. That means any partner, just one partner or any partner just giving notice to quit the business. That means his desire to quit the business and he's just giving a notice, that will be enough for dissolution of the business. And number five, dissolution by the order of the court. When the court is ordering you to dissolve, if any partner becomes insane, that means pagal hoye gelo. If any partner becomes insane, if a partner becomes incapable forever, mane she mane kaj korte jodi chirotore okkhom hoye jay. Number three, if the trust and faith among the partners are affected by the misdeeds of any partner, and that means the main basis of the partnership business is agreement and also the trust and reliability of the partner. So if the trust is just affected by the misdeeds of any partner, then it will be dissolved by the order of the court. And number four, if any partner transfer his share to any third party by violating the terms and condition of the partnership deed, that means you are without any consent of other partners, you are transferring your share to the third party by violating the law of the agreement, then it will be dissolved by the court. And number E, if business is continuously facing loss, then the court will order you to dissolve it. So there are five types of dissolution. First one is with mutual consent. Second one is forced dissolution. Third one is eventual dissolution. Fourth one is dissolution through notice, and fifth one is court, order from the court. Dissolution by the order from the court. So these are the dissolution process. This the partnership business. In the partnership business, the classification of partner is important, very much important, because the classification of this type of partners is just very much informative, and many MCQs or knowledge based questions just arise from this topic. So you have to you have to just concentrate on your lesson when just studying the classification of partnership business. So that's the end of the partnership business. Now I'm gonna start the concept of joint stock company. Joint stock company, if I think you can you just heard that the public limited company, limited company, company, this type, you are just familiar with this word, I think. There are I just know we just know that ever there are private limited company, public limited company. So in total you can say that these are the joint stock companies, joint stock companies. That means joint stock company is where the joint stock, where the capital is more, where the members are more, owners are more, where is management process is just jointly handled, liability is limited, and also the business has a legal entity. This is called the joint stock companies. At first in Britain in 1844 the first joint stock company act just introduced, and this is the important MCQ. 1844 in Britain, the first company act just passed, 1844, which was known as the joint stock company act 1844. This is the first act. This is important MCQ. And in Bangladesh, we are just following the act of 1994, the company act 1994. That means first act is 1844 in Britain, and second important thing is 1994, the company act, which is followed in our country by according to the company act. Okay, features of joint stock company. If you just see the features of joint stock company, then we will clearly understand about the concept of the joint stock company. Joint stock company is legally formed. This business is formed under the prevailing law of the state. Since it is formed legally, its formation is complex and formal. Number of its member is limited by law. In case of private limited company, the number is minimum 2 and maximum 50. And for public limited company, the minimum number is 7 and maximum number is limited by the number of shares. So, this is the joint stock company main concept. And due to legal complications or due to legal formalities, joint stock company is not very much easy to form, but it is if you can form it or if you can establish it, it will be very much profitable business for joint stock company. So it will be very much profitable, and also there is a very much chance to sustain in the current competitive world. So joint stock company is legally formed, and the member of the joint stock company in case of private limited company, it is minimum 2, maximum 50, and public limited company minimum 7, maximum is limited by the number of shares. You can sell your share to the common people of the country, and the number member of this public limited company will be limited by the maximum number of shares. Okay, number two, the joint stock business is an enthusiastic business organization. Several people willingly come together to form and operate company business. That means your willingness is enough to start the business. Number three, since it is legally formed, it has legal personality. That means acting as a person. Acting like a person and enjoying the rights and status like a person. So that's why in case of joint stock companies, it is you can call it as a legal entity or legal personality. So it has the legal personality, and all the transaction, all the activities can be done by the company's name. So that's why it is called the joint stock company has the legal personality. Number four, since company is formed legally, its dissolution must be done under formal legal sanction. That means you have to form the business legally and also just dissolute it in a formal way. Number five, the company has to use a seal of its own name because it has a legal personality. That means there is needed a specific seal. Company has its own seal, and using those seal is necessary while doing the all transaction and all the legal paperwork. Number six, the total capital of the company is divided legally into several small portions. These small portions of capital are called the share. That means you have to sell the share for collecting the capital. This is called share capital. when you accumulate capital or collecting the capital by selling share, that is called the shared capital. And the total amount of capital is divided into small portion, and these small portions are called shared. Number 7, management is totally separate from the ownership in company business. That means management active managerial activities and ownership, those are different things. The owners doesn't participate in the managerial activities of the business. They just employ other persons with the remuneration to do the managerial activities of the business. Number 8, the liability of the member of the company is limited. It is based on your investing capital. That means while you are investing 10,000 taka, that means your liability will be also 10,000 taka. So the liability of member of the company is limited. Number 9, in operation and management of company business, democratic culture and values are followed. Democratic culture, that means they are using the voting system. They are using the voting system and democratic culture just followed in the joint stock company. So these are the characteristics of joint stock company, which by which you can define clearly the joint stock company. And this is also the end of the lecture today, but I am giving you homework and based on your topics, partnership business, I am giving you just a CQ question, and you just have to write it down. You are facing any problem, if you are facing any problem while writing down, please just knock me, I'll help you. Okay, creative question, just follow it. Radim, Nadim and Hasib are a partnership business member. Radim invests capital in the business and also participates in the business management. Nadim invests capital but does not participate in management. That means there are three partners. First one Radim, second Nadim, and third one is Hasib. Radim is ordinary partner because he is investing capital and also participating in the business management. Second one is Nadim invests capital but does not participate in the management or operational activities. Nadim is investing capital but doesn't work. That means he is sleeping partner. And Hasib does not invest capital or take part in the management, but he has a good reputation in business. That means he is allowing the business to use his reputation or name. So that's why he can be called nominal partner. Suddenly, Radim is permanently unable to perform duty due to brain deformity. Brain deformity or insanity, that means mostishko bikriti ba pagol hoye jawa. Brain deformity. Okay, that means Radim just faces the brain deformity. And question is that what is the liability of sole proprietorship business? The liability of sole proprietorship business is unlimited. Which document is called the company's main certificate and why? The main certificate of the company is Memorandum of Association. You will find it page number 51, where there is the process of forming the joint stock company. The document here, preparation of documents, you can find out the main documents. 57. Preparing memorandum of association is called the main document of limited. Follow the cursor points. Memorandum of association is called the main document of limited company. It is also called the main deeds, certificate or constitution of the company. Cause various important issues like name of the company, registered address, objective of business, amount of capital, responsibility of the shareholders, minimum subscription, etc. are incorporated in it or included in it. That's why it is called the memorandum of association is the main document of the company, main certificate of the company, and it is the reason. Number C, what kind of partner Hasib is in the mentioned stem? Hasib is the nominal partner, and you will write down the characteristics of nominal partner, then you just finish the answer. Number D, what is the probability of sustaining the mentioned partnership business? Write it logically. That means what is the probability of sustaining? That means what is the chance of sustaining? That means byabshata tike thakar chance koto tuku. A partnership business ta batike thakar chance hobe. There is no probability of sustaining cause we know that when a ordinary partner became insane or faced brain deformity, then court will order you to dissolve the partnership business.
We just discussed the dissolution of partnership business, and part number five was the
number five was the dissolution by the order of the court. Here you can see that in the dissolution by the order from the court, if any partner becomes insane, then court will order you to dissolute it. So there is no possibility. There is no possibility of sustaining the business. Mentioned partnership business. Just write it logically and explain it. So that will be enough. Okay, this is end for today. Stay tuned and we'll talk later.